Now we know why the Fed wants to reduce interest rates even as stocks are at all-time highs and unemployment is near all-time lows. In a report, the Fed revealed data that clearly shows the pattern of a recession forming unless something changes its course. If they reduce interest rates from this historically low point, they can attempt to stimulate the markets and try to stall the fall. Will they be successful? You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. I saw this report out of the Fed and it was fantastic because they finally admitted the potential, the possibility, oh my goodness, a recession can actually happen. Janet Yellen, please pinch me, I think I'm dreaming. Just the admission that it can happen is now amazing to me. That's how far we have come. But if you think about it, where we are at today with interest rates is incredibly low and they already want to bring that down. But of course, if they do this, if they bring it down a quarter point or maybe even a half a percent, think about what that does. This small range that they've narrowed themselves into becomes even smaller. So we are going to have a very big issue when it comes time and the actual market is starting to slow down heavily. They're going to have less room to work with. That means a problem later on, but that's usually what they do. They simply kick the can down the road. That's the Federal Reserve, that's the government, and it happens to be everywhere also. What we have here is the obvious need to go into the negative. There is only so much that negative interest rates can do. We have seen the failure that exists with negative interest rates, whether we're looking at Europe, whether we're looking at Japan, and so many places have decided to do it. But if you notice, it's not as if they bring it down to negative 2%, negative 5%. That doesn't work like that. They simply bring it down just below the line in order to create that stimulation. It has very minimal effect. And in fact, we have seen no actual positive effect from negative interest rates. So basically what I'm saying is that they are boxing themselves into this corner, big mistake, and they were going to feel it later on, but that's just the way it is. I present you with the data, we look at it, and we will see what happens in the coming days, weeks, and months. Housing is providing another in a line of trouble signs pointing to an economic downturn. I wanted to show you this as soon as I found it. I need to really stress how important this is. Declining home sales are consistent with the possibility of a late 2019 or early 2020 recession. Those are not my words. That is coming directly from the St. Louis Fed economist William Emmons, okay? If there are any challenge to this, if there is any criticism of this, please find William Emmons' email address or phone number and contact him. The analysis overlays home sales over 12 and 36 month periods to look at the trends that have held up during the previous three recessions. When we see patterns, we obviously should be paying attention. Many people ignore it. This time is different. This time is different. Well, you can do that if you want, but it's really up to you. I'll get into more details here and then I'm going to show you the charts that are associated with it. A Federal Reserve economist said the current housing backdrop is similar to the recent economic slumps, with several metrics consistent with the possibility of a late 2019 or early 2020 recession. Of course, when this individual is speaking, you need to really understand that he is working for the Fed. They can only say so much. They're only willing to go so far, but they did give some pretty good stuff, so I'll read it to you. Data on single-family home sales through May 2019 confirmed that housing markets in all regions of the country are weakening. So this is something that we've been covering here on this channel for a while. We know this already, but it's good to hear it from the Fed. The severity of the housing downturn appears comparable across regions in all cases. It's much less severe than the experience leading to the Great Recession, but similar to the periods before the 1991 and 2001 recessions. So this is what others have said. Steve Eisman has said something similar to this. Other economists out there, mainstream economists, have come out and said, well, we'll probably experience a downturn to some degree, but it won't be that bad. Don't worry about it. I personally don't know exactly how it's all going to play out, but all of these things are starting to align and it's important to pay attention to all of the data instead of ignoring it as most do. Let me show you the charts here. They are just something that I wanted to quickly move through. There are four of them. This is the Northeast region. I'll show you the rest. Per capita home sales, deviation of 12-month average from the prior 36-month average, all right? So we compare 1990, 2001, 2007, and 2019. And the yellow line is 2019. And basically what we're seeing is the same pattern happening throughout these different periods. Just showing you that there's a breakdown at the bottom there if you want to read that. I just wanted to show you this. This happens to be the West region per capita home sales, looking at the South region. Same thing every time, essentially, and Midwest. So we see that the patterns are forming here. This is something that people need to understand. It's a widespread issue, despite the fact that we have interest rates that are extremely low. The prices of homes are not where they should be, because when you have interest rates this low, you should be constantly stimulating at the absolute maximum. But there is in fact a ceiling. That's what the Federal Reserve doesn't understand. That's what the government doesn't understand, that you cannot push this out at a rate that you think can go on forever and ever. It doesn't work like that, but you can try. You can try to bring interest rates down all the way so that people don't save their money, so that they invest their money, so that they spend their money, but that eventually leads to a very big problem at some point. You can reduce the amount of delinquencies, because when you have this going on and real estate is rising to new highs all the time, well then it of course allows people to take their home equity line of credit, allows them to pay down their credit card debt, so you see less delinquency, so things appear to be fine. That's all good until real estate falls. Canada is going to get hit very, very hard with this. Australia is already starting to feel it, and you could see that in some areas of Australia down 15%, other areas are down 20%. Look at Perth, look at Sydney as two of the ones that have really come up high and now have been taking a beating as a result. All of the people that have been pulling equity out of their homes, they're in for a real, real problem, and there's no other way to put it. This data here comes from Goldman Sachs, and I wanted to bring it to you. It's interesting to see the admission here when they say monetary policy remains the main support for risk appetite across assets. At least they're admitting it, and that right there is something good for me. When I can actually see this information being presented to the public, it happens to be very honest and upfront. Well, you could see on the very right-hand side, top right-hand side, Fed dovish pivot and the second dovish wave here. Ultimately, we have seen this just recently with the Federal Reserve and what they have done. You could look at all the previous ones. This chart goes back from 2014 up until the present, just giving you an idea of how they had reacted over these years, what has happened as a result. Look, if the Federal Reserve is willing to print and give easy money, then you have risk assets that are going to see much more attractive. Equities happens to be one of those. Certain sectors are obviously going to do better than others. You're going to see ETFs, passive investments, that are doing better than these active funds. Hedge funds are closing. We've discussed this recently. You know the drill. Let me show you this. Pricing of central banks turned more dovish across regions. Central bank discounted rates, dotted line represents market pricing at the end of 2018. Essentially, what we're looking at here is that into the future, we are going to see central banks that are going to bring down interest rates even further, even though we have seen central banks around the world bringing interest rates down to historically low levels, all-time record lows. They need to go even lower, and they're trying to create stimulus out of nothing. There's no way that they are able to do this successfully. They will fail horribly, and even though what we have seen here at the beginning, what I showed you out of the Fed, they're going to realize the consequences of their actions. And then just to finish off the video, wanted to cover this. Even passports are scarce as Zimbabwe runs out of everything. This article is out of Bloomberg. This one here is out of the AP. One article mentions 100% inflation. The other one says 75% inflation. At this point, it doesn't even matter because their money is essentially worthless. People cannot even get US dollars at this point. You know what happens. You know the drill. 10 years ago, they ran into the same problem. Here they are today running into it again. When a country tries to manipulate its currency, it will fail. It always fails. Historically, it happens all the time. You can see this back to the great inflation of Athens back thousands of years ago. There is no difference in what we see today. But of course, that will not stop central bankers from trying, I assure you. That's all for this video. If you found it informative, please hit that like button. By hitting the like button, you support me, so I do appreciate that very much. If you want the financial education you are not taught in school, these two books have everything you need. All the details are located in the link in the description. You're going to find out about the foundation, history, the asset classes, all the details. Click on that link. It'll bring you over there. You can flip through the pages for yourself. If you want the audiobook, that's available at themoneygps.com. Wait a minute, don't go anywhere. You need to watch this video. It's so important. Click on it and I will see you there.